Amazon Bedrock makes it easy to be able to integrate foundation models into your code, and that's exactly what we're going to have a look at in this video. Hello, my name is Mike Chambers, and I'm a developer advocate for Amazon Web Services, working as a specialist in generative AI. So let's just jump into some code and see how we can make it work with Amazon Bedrock. Here inside of Visual Studio Code, I'm running a Jupyter notebook. And of course, you don't have to run your code in a notebook, and it doesn't have to be Python, but those are the choices that I've made for this video. So the first thing that I do in this notebook is to import the Boto3 library, and also I'm going to import JSON as well. So we're going to use that later on when we're making some generation. And the next thing that I do, well, this is the important thing, creating the Bedrock client in Boto3. So we do that with this piece of code here. So we use the Boto3 client, we ask for the service name of the Bedrock runtime, and then we choose the region that we're working in. So let me run that so I've got that defined. Now in my code, I'm going to start to do some prompting. What prompt do I want to send to the model? In this particular case, it's super, super simple. I'm just going to pass in hello, and then we'll get more complicated and more involved as we go through this video. But for now, let's just call hello. The prompt is going to be that. Now, how do I wrap that up in order to send it to the API endpoint? Well, I need some keyword arguments to pass in. Where do I get those from? Well, I'm going to get them from the AWS Amazon Bedrock console. So let's go to the console page here. And then from here, I'm going to go to the menu on the left-hand side and go to Playgrounds Text. Now, let me just collapse the menu just for a second so we got some more space. And then I'm going to select the large language model, the foundation model that I want to use. In this case, I'm going to use AI21 Labs, and I'm going to choose Jurassic 2 Ultra. Now, with this playground, I can type in a prompt directly into the playground and start to experiment with some prompt engineering. So if I type in hello, I could run it right here, but I don't want to do that. What I'm going to do is scroll down and click on View API Request. And this gives me a snippet of code, which I can take and put in my own code. And that's exactly what we're going to do. So let's press copy and then go back to my code. And if I scroll down here, I've got this space ready for some keyword arguments. So let me paste that into there. Now at the moment, hello is hard coded into the body prompt of these keyword arguments. So let's adjust that. I'm going to put in some really simple string concatenation and just insert my prompt into the middle of that. So now these things are wired together. Let me press run on that. It's also going to print it out just so that we can see it. So you can see here all of the keyword arguments that I have for sending into the model. And you can see inside of here, I've got my prompt constructed in there as well. So that's what I need to pass in. And then this line of code here is where all the magic happens. So Bedrock runtime, invoke model. It's the same API endpoint. It's the same command that we're going to use for any of the Amazon Bedrock Foundation models that we want to invoke. Now, there is another way you can do it as well, and we'll look at that in just a second, but this will work for all of the models. So let's run that and see what the response is that we get back. Well, the response is this. It's what we call a streaming body object from Boto3. We need to unpack this in order to get at the generation. And I'm going to go and do this sort of the long-handed way so you can see the steps. But of course, you can just lump all of these lines together and just do it in one go if you wanted to. So with this response object, we need to read out of it the body object. And so let's go and do that in this one line here. So we're going to unpack the JSON string from here. We're going to get the body. We're going to read that. Let's have a look at what that looks like. So if you run that, this is the response we get back. A whole bunch of values that we're getting out of the model, out of the Jurassic model. So the developers of the model created the output that looks like this. Loads and loads of rich detail in here, including the completions. So we've got completions. Inside of there, we've got a list that includes data, text, and the actual completion that we want. Super simple prompt of hello, and the response is, how can I help you today? So how are we going to just grab that out It's just a little bit of object manipulation here. We're going to get the completion from that response body. The first thing in the completion list, we're going to, actually it's completions, the completions list, then we're going to get the data, get the text, and then we're going to finally just have a look at the completion. So we do that and we get the response back. How can I help you today? So super easy to be able to work with the code snippet from the console and then actually create our generation. Let's have a look at using a different model. So if I just go to my next tab here, we're going to play around with Claude in this example. So exactly the same start. I'm going to import Boto3 JSON and then go and get my Boto3 client object. So let's run that. Now my prompt this time is going to be a little bit more in depth, just because why not? This is more realistic for the kind of prompt that we might want to send in to a foundation model. And in this case, it says, we've received some text without any context. We need to label the text with a title so that others can quickly see what this text is about. In other words, this is basically a summarization task, but it's a summarization task which works in a small prompt for the sake of this demo. And what I've done is I've said that I'm going to supply the text inside of these XML tags, which I've done, and the text reads like this. Today, I went to the beach and saw a whale. I ate an ice cream and swam in the sea. Sounds like I had a fantastic day. Okay, and I'm asking it to provide a title for that so that we could use that to label this data. And I'm asking it to provide that inside of some title XML tags. A really handy way to do some prompt engineering so that when we get our completion, we can make sure that we can do some checking on what we get back and make sure it's what we think it is. So I'm going to set that as my prompt. I'm going to escape it so that any line breaks, of which there are many, are going to be properly escaped. And we're going to set that up as our prompt. Now we're going to send this into Claude, and so exactly the same thing. If I want to know the parameters that I need in order to be able to send this into Claude, let's go back to the AWS console. I'll just close this down, go back up to the top, and we're going to choose Anthropic, and then let's say Claude V2 as our model. Now, when I go down this time and click on View API Request, something's happened. The console understands that we're working with Claude, and so it's used the Anthropic style of prompt, which is human colon, and then what we wanted to say, and then assistant colon, and then after that, our generation will come. So that's how we need to construct the prompt. So let's copy that. Let's move back into our code. I'm just going to paste it over this section here. And the same thing again, I'm just going to replace this with my prompt. So I'm just going to put a couple of quotes in there and just do some simple string concatenation to bring those two things together. If I can spell prompt, there we go. And let's just print that out. And so now we've got our keyword arguments, and that includes the prompt that we have here, which is prompt human colon. We have received some text without any context, etc., etc. So let's go and run that through Invoke model, passing those keyword arguments in, get our response back. There we go. We've got our streaming body response. We're going to unpack that. We're going to get the body out. And this time the completion is much simpler. We've just got this completion and then the actual completion there. In fact, we can pretty much see it directly there. But for the sake of completeness for our completion, let's go ahead and run this cell and get our final completion out. And I left the S in there. Let's run that again. It's completion, not completions. And so there you have it, a day at the beach, which is the title it's given for the story I gave, which was about me and a day at the beach. So that's pretty good. I like that. And so there's one more thing I want to show you before we finish up this video, and that's that Invoke model isn't the only way to get the generation out. We also can get a streaming invocation out. And so let's have a look at that in this tab here. So the first thing I need to do, exactly the same, we're just going to import the Boto3 library, get our Boto3 client object. Then we're going to set up a different prompt here. Write an article about a fictional planet called FUBAR. Okay, so it's going to produce for us a whole body of text. So let's make sure I run that so that we've got that defined. Then we've got our keyword arguments. This is all ready to go for us. We're using the Claude V2 model because that supports a streaming output. So let's run that. We've got our keyword arguments set up for it. And then here is where everything happens. So we're not calling invoke model. This time we're calling invoke model with response stream. So the generation is streaming out to us and we get to see the beginning of the output before the end has been created. So if you want to make something like a chatbot and you want to have an interactive session and you want to capture the attention of the person who's reading the content back before the whole generation is being completed, then you can use this call. Let me show you what I mean. What we're going to do is we're going to call invoke model with response stream. We're going to then get the body out of that response. And then we're going to say, okay, that's a stream. We're going to get the events out of that stream. And then for each event, we're going to get what we call the chunk. And that chunk of data is the chunk of the generation. We're going to get it chunk by chunk so that we can show it sequentially. And then for each of those, we're going to print them to the screen. Let me show you. This is the response for the large language model writing an article about the fictional planet FUBAR. Let me press run and it starts to run. And so straight away, we start to get the generation streaming out of the model. We don't have to wait for the whole generation. And you can see it's still going there and it's going right across the page and on it'll go until it's finished writing its article. So there you have it, how you can use BOTO3, the SDK for Python in AWS, to interact with Amazon Bedrock using those little code snippets from the console. I hope you found this useful. I hope you found this interesting. If you liked this video, then please do subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so that you can see more videos just like this. Press the like if you did like it, and I will see you in the next video.